dudes, dudettes, and everything in between, I'm Rayez, and welcome to Let's Talk Episode 7. Now, I did not plan to come across a video idea at about 9:30 p.m., but I did. I was browsing YouTube late at night, watching some J-Schlatt, Quackity watching Mexican soap operas, when a video popped up in my recommended titled Top 100 Scariest Public Service Announcements. I happen to be a huge fan of scary PSAs, so I clicked on the video and was led down a rabbit hole of PSAs I didn't even know existed. Even the Stop It, Get Some Help PSA was there. You remember that vine?
Stop it. Get some help.
I didn't even know it was from a drug PSA until last night. I thought it was just a vine. I will admit, that one was very close to making it on this list as just an icebreaker in between the nightmarish PSAs, but I wanted to stay true to my title, so I did not include it. Anyway, I've compiled a top 10 list of scariest and or saddest public service announcements that either made me incredibly depressed, made me almost piss myself, or a little bit of both. They are in no particular order either, so I hope you enjoy. Number 1, Waiting by Budweiser. In this PSA, it starts off by showing a cute little doggo and its owner bonding and playing, the dog kissing his face, and it deserves 10,000 puppy dog eye emojis. But then it shows the owner leaving, the dog just laying down with a sad look, his eyes becoming sadder and sadder as the hours tick by, a caption saying, "For some, the waiting never ended." Now, thankfully, its owner does come home, and he says he got drunk, so he stayed the night at his friend's, but it made this list because seeing the doggo's sad face with the words, "For some, the waiting never ended," ripped my heart out.
Welcome home, buddy.
You and me, we were made for love. A lifetime is not long enough to show you what you mean to me.
See you later, buddy. Hey, I'm sorry. I decided I shouldn't drive home last night. I stayed at Dave's.
When you come on,
I'm back
to me.
Yeah, I'm back.
You might as well be stabbing me if you're gonna show me that. I can't even make any jokes. It's just depressing. 2, all CDC smoking commercials. I say all of them because all of them scare the living shit out of me, especially the ones that say they died like 2 days later. I've always been highly against smoking, but those commercials make me want to vomit. They're scary and hit close to home because I have several family members that smoke, a couple which I am very close to. So I imagine them ending up like that, and it's terrifying to me. And in general, it just sends a chill down my spine.
I'm at age 13. And at age 17 is when I really started smoking on a regular basis. And then in 2000 is when I found the little solar.
Number 3, Shadows, the Meth Project. PSA starts by showing a guy who is clearly delusional and having hallucinations, saying they're here. When his mom asks who, he says them, and goes to grab a baseball bat, smashing things in a fit of rage and paranoia, before he starts trying to hit his mom, yelling, "I'll kill you." The reason I made it onto this list is because of the pure terror the mom feels and the aggressive behavior the son exhibits.
They're out there.
Who?
Them! Shithead, they're everywhere! They're gonna kill me!
No, Anthony!
No!
This isn't normal.
No!
But on meth?
No! Who are you?
It is.
I'll kill you!
Four. I didn't mean to add counsel. So this one shows the drawings of a little boy who is narrating this PSA. And he shows a drawing of his brother. And because of where this is going, I will not be making any jokes about the art like I normally would. He then shows his brother drawn dead with a bullet hole in his stomach while the little boy says, "I didn't mean to shoot daddy's gun. I didn't mean to. I didn't mean to." Which is incredibly frightening and depressing, especially to hear the pure pain and terror in the boy's voice.
This is my brother Omar. Well, there was a hole in his tummy. A bullet hit him. I saw red grass. The gun was in the garage. I didn't mean to shoot daddy's gun.
Five. Tick. Ad Council. This is another PSA by Ad Council, and it showcases several children saying tick. And as it goes on, their voices get even angrier and more painful as they list some of the things global warming causes. But it's on here because of the nature of the children's faces and how the longer it goes, the more pained they become. Number 6, Everything Else, The Meth Project. Another one by The Meth Project. This one shows us a young girl at a party coming out to see what a group of people are doing. And when the girl asks for a hit of the meth they're doing, the guy says to give her some, but then lists everything that comes along with doing meth, such as, these are your meth addict friends, this is your meth addict boyfriend. This will be your meth addict face.
Hey, what about me?
Hey, what about you?
Oh, come on.
Give her some.
Yeah, give me some.
All right, all right. You want meth, kid? Here's your meth. And here's your meth dealer. And your meth boyfriends. And your meth baby. Don't forget your meth face.
Number 7, The Meth Project. Again. Honestly, this organization has some of the scariest PSAs out there. It shows a young girl, presumably Kevin's sister, naming the places where he did things because of meth. Like the hospital where he almost died, place where he did it right after he got out, and the scariest, where he ended his life because he said he couldn't quit. And then the girl says, "This is what I said when he told me he was gonna try meth." With her looking so hurt, her eyes filled with tears.
This is where he went into convulsions. This is the emergency room where he nearly died. This is where he smoked it again, right after he got out. This is where he hung himself, because he said he couldn't quit. And this is what I said when he told me he was gonna try meth.
Number 8. Candle. California Department of Public Health. This is another anti-smoking one where the woman is sitting in front of a candle, her face deformed, her voice raspy, swallowing and pausing every 2 seconds, as she talks, saying how much she regrets smoking and how you should quit before it is too late. And then the candle goes out as she grabs her throat, fading into darkness.
My name is Debbie. This may be my last chance to warn you about the dangers of smoking. Gradually, tobacco took not just my health, but my dreams. Think about what tobacco is taking from you. Quit now before it's too late.
Number 9, Baby Invasion, Truth. This one shows a bunch of robotic babies crawling around the streets while people just look at them. This goes on for a while before one of the robot babies tips over to reveal the caption, "How do babies avoid secondhand smoking? They learn to crawl." And finally, at number 10, Evan, the Sandy Hook Promise. This one starts by showing us a boy named Evan, writing on a desk, "I'm so bored," and comes back the next day to a response in cursive. This goes back and forth for a while, Evan trying to figure out who is responding to his writing, and at the end, he writes in a girl's yearbook and does. But while they're properly introducing themselves, a student bursts through the door with a gun while everybody screams before fading to black, saying, "While you were watching Evan, another student was showing signs of planning a school shooting."
I got some news today from the radio man. He spoke the words somber and as softly as he can. The world stood still and the sky opened up. I made my way to fill up my coffee cup. Then it occurred to me as the daylight sky shone blue, today's the day that Johnny met June. He waited a while, he knew that he would. He was gonna hang around here for as long as he could. The days went by, and hours idle passed. He was never sure just how long he would last. But there's not much love in a lonely room. Today's the day that Johnny met June.
Have a good summer.
You too.
Thanks.
Hey, you must be bored.
No way.
This is the guy that I was running to in the library.
You're kind of,
oh. Yeah.
Like guilty. So.
Oh my God.
So you like to write on desks?
Yeah, that's what I do.
Which I don't know about you guys, but I didn't notice anything, which is terrifying. Maybe I'm just not incredibly observant. I have no idea. Anyway, that's gonna be it for this video. If you want to see more of my content, consider subscribing if you'd like. I love you guys, stay safe, and never let anybody take your crown.
That's what you get for being pretty. So greedy, that's what you get for being greedy. Oh, that's what you get for being greedy. Oh, that's what you get. Nowhere to run, nowhere to go. Hurry up, I've got a bet to win. The time is-
sinking, you move too slow, so pay off the debt to save your skin. Fight one-on-one, run and